Starting with the second part of this chapter, in which we'll see about the kinematic chain and the degrees of freedom calculation, links, how can we count links and number of pairs, number of joints, etc. And then we can define lock chain and all. So let's start. So earlier we have seen the definition for link and types of link, and the degrees of freedom calculation for a link can be very easy. While now we'll see the same thing for the joints, so the type of joints and all. So in a kinematic chain, so kinematic pairs are coupled in such a way that the last joint is linked to the first to transmit a definite motion. So we put some motion to the first link, and due to the connectivity, the last link will have a definite required motion as per our requirement. So we can transmit some energy from one point to another point using this kinematic chain. So in other words, a kinematic chain may be defined as a combination of kinematic pairs. So these are kinematic pairs, these are all binary links joined in such a way that each link forms a pair of two, part of two pairs. So this link 2 is a part of this and this link only, and the relative motion between the link or element is completely or successfully constrained, and it is, there are no incompletely constrained links. And here we limit ourselves to such links which form a part of only two pairs. So let's see, there are two definitions for being a chain or kinematic chain. So in a kinematic chain, each link forms a part of two pairs, which I said earlier. Therefore there can be as many pairs, so there can be a relation of number of pairs and number of joints, and number of pairs and number of links. There are two relations, and here I have already stated there are only two, each forms a part of only two pairs, and these pairs must be lower pairs only. So there cannot be a point contact here. So this is the first relation, which give relation between number of links and number of pairs. And then we'll see how can we count the number of pairs also. Number of links can be counted very easily. So between two joints, we have a link. And another relation is between the number of links and number of joints, and they are also with lower pairs only. So the number of joints is equal to 3 by 2 L minus 2. So we'll use these two relations to define that a given such a system makes a kinematic chain or not. So that kinematic chain is able to transmit the motion or not. So we can define that. So let's say we have first example, which is a triangle something like this. So we have 3. L is equal to 3, number of pairs are 3, and number of joints are 3. So let's count joints. So A, this one, these two, and this is the third. There are 3 pin joints. Number of links are 3, link 1, link 2, link 3. And we can count number of pairs by, so the first and second joint makes one pair, then this another pair, and there is another pair. So this there are 3 pairs available. And when we put this L, P and J in this formula, then we can see that the LHS, that is L, is less than 2P minus 4, and similarly here J is less than 3 by 2 L minus 2. So in such a situation, they are going to be greater. 2P minus 4 is going to be less, and L is greater than 2P minus 4. Similarly here J will be greater than 3 by 2 L minus 2. So in that case, we'll say that it is a lock chain and there are no degrees of freedom left to us. So it is a rigid structure, and such structures are used for making truss, which we have seen in MOS, mechanics of solid. The truss are having such structures in them. Then we have a kinematic chain which has a 1 degree of freedom. So let's see this example. So we have 4 pin joints. There are 4 pairs and there are 4 links. When we put this L, P and J values in this formula, we'll see LHS is equal to RHS. Here also LHS is equal to RHS. And in such situation, we can say that this given chain makes a kinematic chain, and this can be used for transmitting some force from first link to the last link in a definite way. And then we have a unconstrained chain. It means that since we have five links, five joints and five pairs, when we put LP and J values here, we'll see that LHS is less than 2P minus 4. Here also LHS is less than RHS. Hence, we'll see that the chain is not constrained enough. There are more number of joints and there are more number of links than the number of pairs which are available, or there couldn't be more constraints which we can apply on this, and hence this chain cannot be used. So the relative motion is not completely constrained in here. So there are two more than 1 degrees of freedom available. We had earlier seen the type of links, which were binary links, quaternary links and tertiary links, and now we'll see the classification for joints. So we have binary joint, tertiary joint and a quaternary joint. So binary joint means it is when two links are joined at the same connection, that joint is called as a binary joint. And tertiary joint means when three links are connected. So this joint E, when there are three links connected to at the same connection, then it is called as a tertiary joint. So joint E makes a tertiary joint. So joint C also makes a tertiary joint. And for quaternary joint, there are four links which are connected to the same connection. So here at point C, 2, 9, 10 and 3, there are four links connected at this point C. Hence this point C makes a quaternary joint, while point G will make a tertiary joint, point F will make a tertiary joint, point E will also make a tertiary joint, and point D makes a binary joint. And then we can, there is one relation given which will define the type of joint, and will it therefore, so it can say the constraint level of the joints. So there are more joints, there are less joints, we can figure out from this relation. So here the relation says J plus H by 2 is equal to 3 by 2L minus 2. So J is the number of binary joints, H is the number of higher pairs. So we had earlier defined the lower pair and higher pair concept. So the higher pair means then there is a connection between two links, and the connection has made only at a point, or there is a line joint, a line connection. And L is the number of links. So here in the first there are four links. Here we have four links, there are no higher pair, so H is zero. There are four links and there are four joints, and when we put that L, J and L, J in our formula, we'll see that the LHS is equal to RHS, and therefore the chain is the kinematic chain. When we see for the tertiary case, here we'll see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There are 6 links. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 joints, and there are no higher pair. So we'll see that the LHS is again equal to RHS, and hence this can be a kinematic chain or a constrained chain. And for a quaternary joint, we can see that there are around 11 links, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 joints and no higher pair. And here we will see that LHS is greater than RHS, and hence such a type of chain is a lop chain, and this is a rigid structure and cannot be used as a kinematic chain for transmitting our force. Now let's see the difference in mechanism. So mechanism, machines and that definition. So when one of the link of a kinematic chain is fixed, the chain is known as mechanism. So here all the links were free to move, so we can so this was a lock chain, so we cannot move this structure. But when we move this one, the 2, 3 and 4 all have unknown motion as of now, and none of the links are fixed and none of the joint is fixed, so it cannot be used as some definite motion machine. While when we fix one of the link in a kinematic chain, then it becomes a mechanism, and a mechanism with four link is known as simple mechanism. So this makes a simple mechanism, while the mechanism with more than four links are known as compound mechanism. So this will be known as compound mechanism. And when a mechanism is required to transmit power or to do some particular type of work, then it becomes a machine. So when we use this structure, this joint structure to transmit some force, then it becomes a machine. So machine is an assemblage of parts that transmit forces, motion or energy in a predetermined manner. So we design our chains and links and joints in such a way that we have a definite required motion at the end. So with the planar mechanism, what it means that all the links of a mechanism have in plane motion and they will not go out of a plane. And earlier we counted the number of degrees of freedom of a link and a joint and all. So now for a complete mechanism, we'll see how can we calculate the number of degrees of freedom. And degrees of freedom is also known as the mobility of the mechanism. And for that purpose, we'll use the Kurzweil criteria equation for determining number of degrees of freedom. And this criteria is only applicable for planar mechanisms, which we are studying right now. So here J means number of single degree of freedom pairs or total number of lower pairs. H means number of 2 degree pairs or 2 degree of freedom pairs or total number of higher pairs. So we'll generally stick to this number of lower pairs and number of higher pairs, but when the calculation gets more complex, we can also shift to J as number of single degree of freedom pairs and H as number of 2 degrees of freedom pairs. As per the example, we can swap between the definition. But when we use this J as lower pairs, don't use H as number of 2 degrees of freedom, but because lower pairs will have some cases when there are 2 degrees of freedom. So please stick to the convention. L is the number of links and N will give the number of degrees of freedom. So we'll see there are many number of cases. I have used M. So N and M both are swap. So M is the degrees of freedom. So when N is greater than 0, the mechanism has N degrees of freedom. When N is 0, the motion is not possible and it becomes a truss, or the mechanism forms a structure like the bridges we have. And when N is equal to 1, the mechanism can be driven by single input motion. So one of the link can be moved in such a way that the end link will move as per our requirement. When N is equal to 2, two separate input motions are necessary to produce constrained motion of the mechanism. So for required motion at the end, there are two types of motion for input are required to generate the required output. And when N is equal to minus 1 or there is a negative number for N, there are redundant constraints in the chain and it forms a statistically indeterminate structure. And here we are having more number of links here. More number of links are there than the number of joints and higher pairs. So we can remove some of the links. So something like we form when we form something like sorry I don't have some but for such a structure, when there are four joints and four links, and when we put another link connecting from this joint to another joint, then it becomes a closed structure. It cannot move in any way. And if we joined this joint to another this joint and we put a link in here, so we'll have six links and four joints, and this will become a redundant structure. So it is a truss like a structure and there are no degrees of freedom left, so we'll have negative degrees of freedom in that case. So let's see some examples. So I had an example here. So here this is a 3-bar mechanism. So we have L is equal to 3 number of joints as 3, and there is one. So we saw for becoming a mechanism, we must have one of the link as fixed link. So here we have fixed one of the link, that is the link between joint A and joint B. And degrees of freedom are 0. So this is not useful for us. Then we have a four bar mechanism. So there are 4 links, there are 4 joints, and we can see there is 1 degree of freedom left to us. So we can move any one of the link. So generally we'll move the link number 2, it will rotate. So C will rotate about B, and the link 4 will have some definite motion as required. So we'll study different types of 4 bar mechanisms which are useful and which are applied in our industry. Then we have 5 bar mechanism. So in this case, there are 5 links, there are 5 joints, and degrees of freedom are 2. So we need to have input to 2 links at least, or 2 joints, to have a definite motion of the of our structure. So we can move link 2 and link 5 simultaneously as per the requirement, and the output motion of point D may be the required output. Then we have 5 bar mechanism, another 5 bar mechanism, which is like this. So there are 5 joints, there are 5 links, and there are 6 joints, sorry, there are 4 joints only. 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 5 pairs, sorry. Okay, so these are the pairs, lower pairs. We have counted them as the lower pairs. So there are 6 pairs available. 1, 2, 2, 3, 2, 5, 3, 5, and 1, 4, 4, 5. So there are 6 pairs available, and degrees of freedom is 0. So this also becomes a truss structure, and this is not useful in the mechanism or a machine. Then there is 6 bar mechanism. So here we have L is equal to 6 and J is equal to 0. So this is also not a useful structure. Then let's see a complex mechanism, which is a question from a competitive question. So exam. So here we have 6 links, and there are 7 lower pairs, or 7, we can count them. So this is 1. This is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5th and 6th. So there are 6 links, and don't count this triangular link as 3 different links from this joint to this joint, because it has been shown as a solid link. So this is a single link. And here also we don't have any degrees of freedom, so this is not useful structure. And you can count for this example also. So there are, so the links are already been described here, and please be sure that this is a solid hash line, and hence this is a single link. Let's see more complex mechanisms also. So here there are 4 links, 3 lower pairs, and there are no higher pairs. So this is one of the links. So this is the fixed link. So all the fixed are counted as only 1. So we don't count these 3 fixed as 3 individual. There are they are counted as single link, and the degrees of freedom are negative 1. So this is not a useful structure. Then there are 2 discs jointed from some pin joint, and that pin joint has been a fixed link. So there are 3 links, there are 2 lower pairs. So this is one pair, that is this pin joint and this disc, this pin joint and this disc, and there is one higher pair, that is the line movement or line contact over here, or a point contact at the contact of these 2 discs. So we have 1 degree of freedom, and we can see that a similar structure is made, but we have welded this, so the movement, the rotation is not possible. So over here we have 3, L is equal to 3, J is equal to 2, and 1 higher pair. So that is the point contact or the line contact, and we have 1 degree of freedom. Okay, we end over here. Next we'll see more complex 4 bar mechanism, because the 4 bar mechanism was one where we had 1 degree of freedom, and then we can make some complex 4 bar mechanism to do as per the requirement of in our industry. Okay, thank you.